Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Oh, welcome back to Black Rose TV NG. My name is Rogay Muhammad Thalith, and if this is your first time on my channel, I'm glad to have you. Do me a favor by clicking on that subscribe button and don't forget to ring on that notification bell so you get notified when any video is being uploaded. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being here. I'm really pleased to have you and thank you so much for the support. So in this video, you guys, can you believe it? Ramadan is like, we're in the sixth day of Ramadan today, inshallah. So it's kind of scary, to be honest. Like, it was just yesterday we were talking about Ramadan is just around the corner, a few days to Ramadan. We are counting down to Ramadan. And today we are counting out of Ramadan. Can you guys believe it? I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way we have witnessed the beginning of this month, may He spare our lives to witness the end of it and also more Ramadan to come in the future. Ameen ya Rab. So in this video, I am going to be talking about a very vital act of ibadah that we do in Ramadan and a few tips that are going to help you perform that act of ibadah in a very beautiful way. It is none other than that dua. So please do stick with me to the end of this video to know. And in this video, I'll be talking about the best time to make dua. And also, I have something for you guys. It's like an adhkar timetable. For those of you that have a hard time switching their adhkar, I've got you covered because I also do that. I have a very hard time switching, you know, between my adhkars and my supplications. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through it. But before I start, I have to put this up there. I am not a scholar. Please, you guys, I'm not a scholar. I am just firsthand this video. My videos are mostly a reminder to me and then you guys. So I feel like if I'm going to film a video and to remind myself, the least I can do and the least I can do justice to myself is to implement them in my life as well. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about the best time for you to make dua. I'm not going to list all of them, just a few crucial, vital times in Ramadan that we shouldn't miss. The first is during suhoor. If you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during that period of suhoor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua because you are making dua in the last hour of the night. We all know that the time for suhoor is a very blessed, it has a lot of blessings, abundant blessings in that time. So if you, and please do not be forming that I'm strong, I can fast without suhoor. Suhoor doesn't mean, I have my set of Ramadan series which I have talked about iftar and suhoor. It's going to come up here. So do check this video. Do check it out after watching this video. You don't need to take large amount of food when you're doing suhoor. Just a sip of water can serve as suhoor. The logic is for you to just put something in your stomach at that time for you to be able to benefit from the abundant blessings of that and for you to just benefit from the blessings of suhoor. So while you're doing that, instead of sleeping till when it's Fajr for you to wake up and pray, why don't you wake up, take a sip of water and then pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Him to guide you. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let out all your problems to Him. By the will of Allah, if you pray in this time, your dua will be answered just like an arrow is being fired from a bow. And we know how straight it hits. Inshallah, your dua will be answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also another time is the time of iftar. Obviously, these two times, they are very beautiful. They are blessed, especially in Ramadan, because the time for suhoor, you are eager, you want to take up your fast. And the time for iftar, you're tired, but still you are keeping it until you hear the adhan. That time, Allah loves it when we pray to Him. Especially this time for iftar, it is not time for you to keep your recitation, to continue your Quranic recitation. It is not the time for you to, you know, pray nawafil. It is not the time for you to do other acts of ibadah. That time is time for you. It is a time meant for you. Just you and Allah Azza wa Jal. Ask Him your deepest desire. Ask Him what is beneath your heart, like all that you want Him to fulfill for you in your life. Ask Him to grant you rahmah. Ask Him to forgive you. Pray for the Muslim Ummah. That time when you pray in that specific time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it and He appreciates it when we ask Him. And we all know that Allah is the most generous and He is all-giving and all-knowing. So do not hesitate to make dua during that time. After suhoor and just before iftar, these times they are gold, they are worth, they are priceless, to be honest. And then another time is obviously when a person is fasting and he prays, his prayer will be answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is a golden hour on the day of Jumu'ah. When you pray in that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also answers your dua. He forgives your sin. Whatever you ask him, he is going to grant you. And that hour, but the scholars have said it is the time after Asr till Maghrib. That period of time from Asr till Maghrib, it is a very beautiful time. It is a very powerful time for one to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want your dua to be answered, like instantly, just pray to Allah. I have a video of how Allah replies to our dua. Sometimes the video is coming up right after this video, at the end of this video. That is why I want you guys to stick with me till the end of the video. And then another time that you can make dua and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua is after the adhan. When the adhan is being called and you make supplicate, you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is going to answer your dua. Especially if you're praying in congregation, the angels are surrounded, you are surrounded by the angels. They are going to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you what you have asked him for. So please do not hesitate, do not take these times for granted. Another time that we kind of take for granted or we don't give much importance is when you are traveling. If you happen to find yourself as a traveler, if you happen to travel, please do not hesitate to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because when you are traveling, you are alone and you kind of focus on yourself and other things. You ponder, especially if you are traveling by road, you ponder upon the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see the wonders of the world, and when you're traveling by road, it is risky, to be honest. Like, it is not guaranteed. If you're traveling, it is not guaranteed that you might reach your destination. It is not guaranteed that you might see your family again. It is not guaranteed that you might be able to breathe the next air. You might not be able to take in your next oxygen. So please pray when you are traveling. Do not hesitate. Make lots of dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will answer your prayer because you are alone. You are just with him. You have to focus. You have to, you know, be engaged in that moment. Take it, use it, make the most out of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it when we call unto him. He loves it when we ask him. So in this period, please do not hesitate to make dua to the Muslim Ummah. Muslims around the world, Muslims in China, Muslims suffering, refugees. We know the world is ending and things are deteriorating. Things are getting bad. Things are getting out of hand every day. If we do not pray for ourselves, then I don't believe we're going to make it. But when we pray and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect and guide us, he is going to help us. So the other thing that we're going to talk about in this video is switching your adhkar. I like to call it my adhkar timetable because I find it hard to stick to schedules or to kind of, you know, follow, I'm a spontaneous person, and at the same time I'd like to stick to some schedules. It's complicated, you guys. So I found this, I came across it on a friend's WhatsApp story. So I thought to myself, I'm not going to keep this alone to myself. I'm going to share it with you guys all. So in the timetable, I'm going to pop it up, but I am not going to follow that exact timetable. I'm going to share with you my own personal timetable that I have made out of that. It's like an inspiration to me to make my own timetable. My own in the morning, after Fajr, that is the time for you to make supplications. Like, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. This is the adhkar that I will be seeing from that time. And then after that, if you're going to sleep, if you're going to go on with your daily activities, you can go then. After that, like, from after Dhuhr till Asr, you can make istighfar. A lot of istighfar, but my own personal favorite is Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. And also the Prophet ﷺ has told us the benefits of this powerful supplication. Kalimatani khafifatani, thaqilatani fil mizani, habibatani ila rahman. Two words, they are heavy on the scale, light on the tongue, and they are most loved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these two words are Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. So, and you guys, you know the bonus of these words. If you say them 100 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins, no matter how big your sins are, no matter how many your sins are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive everything. So do not hesitate to make this supplication in Ramadan. And also from that period, like I have noticed that I just need to say that 100 times. So if you're going to, maybe you might want to sleep, because most people sleep between Dhuhr till Asr. That time people take siesta. So you might do something else. If you want, you might add something up. But for me, this is just that I'm going to take, because most people sleep during that time. And also after Asr till Maghrib. That time, I feel like it is the time for me to thank Allah and also glorify Him. So, and then another adhkar that you might want to do, you might want to engage in after Dhuhr is La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. We are going through a lot every day in our lives. We are struggling from different aspects of our lives. Physically, maybe it could be health, it could be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might test us with our health, our wealth, our ability, our intellect, our mental ability. Through a lot of things, we are struggling. So when you sincerely make this supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bi idhnillah, He will ease your affairs. And then from then till after Dhuhr, from you can make this supplication throughout from Dhuhr till Asr. So after Asr, just change it with something. Alhamdulillah, you can thank Allah for what He has given you, because if you're a Muslim, we are always going to be thanking Allah. In whatever state we find ourselves, we need to thank Allah Azza wa Jal. So you can maybe just do Alhamdulillah. I am also, you can just switch it up with Alhamdulillah, as I have said. And then from that time to a few minutes till Maghrib, that time is a time for you to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I've stated earlier. So after Maghrib, that time is for you to eat, to let your senses come back to, you know, digest things, process, just be at peace, just sit down. Trust me, try this. After Maghrib, if you have eaten, you have taken your iftar, just before Taraweeh, just try sitting and be quiet. Don't say a word to anyone. Be quiet. Just sit. Trust me, you are going to do this from the day you started. You are going to keep doing it till after Ramadan, because that time you are giving yourself the ability to just sit down, think for yourself, calm down through the struggles that you went through the day. You are allowing your own body to calm down, to relieve all the stress that you have gone through. The feeling that you have the moment you break your fast is beautiful. It is different because you just feel some, like a sense of relief. You feel, especially if you take water, you just feel that, you know, we all know how it feels. So, but this one is different. It's like you're allowing your own self to calm down. You're not just calming your own mind, but your body as well is calming down, because when you're quiet, you know, like everything is quiet, everything is calm in your body. And then after Taraweeh, like from 10 till the time you're going to sleep, you can do any kind of adhkar. You can switch it up from La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. You can say Allahu Akbar, because God is great. I mean, He's the greatest. Allahu Akbar. You can keep repeating this. I'm not necessarily you guys. And also, I have a package for you. Inshallah, at the end of every video, I will give you guys a package. It is the month of Ramadan. Ad-Dunya Ramadan, ya jama'a. We need to be generous. If I cannot give you something physical, at least I can give you something that can help you with your fasting. And something that it's just a reminder, but I'm just giving you, it's like a bonus from me. So this is nothing but a supplication. And this supplication is a very powerful supplication. So whatever situation you might find yourself in, whatever condition you find yourself in, good, bad, it works anytime you say it. And this supplication is Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum bi rahmatika astaghith aslih li sha'ni kullahu wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfat 'ayn. If you say this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see you through whatever situation you're going through. He will help you, He will ease up your affairs. So do not hesitate to keep repeating this whenever you find yourself struggling. And if you find yourself in a state that it is good for you, say Alhamdulillah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it when we thank Him, and He loves it when we call upon Him to help us. So this is it, you guys. We have come to the end of this video. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. If you find it beneficial, share it with a friend. Be generous, just like I've given you this package. Share it with a friend, and inshallah, you'll get the reward as well. Whatever I have said that is not correct, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me and forgive my shortcomings. And whatever I have said that is beneficial, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward me and also reward you guys by sharing it. And also don't forget to comment if I have left anything unsaid or I have made a mistake. Feel free to correct me in the comment section. And this video, I want to hit for 350 subscribers on this video. So yeah, 350 subscribers just for this video. I'm not aiming too much because I have a video coming up about my own YouTube journey. I know I have not, like, I'm not that big of a YouTuber, but to be honest, you guys, I can say I have had my own share of YouTube. I have my own share of YouTube story that I can relate to other people. So I can't wait for that video as well. I know you're all eager, and I am also eager to share that video with you. So this is the end of it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Meet you in my next video.